Armed Taliban soldiers have stationed themselves at checkpoints in Kabul as residents in the Afghan capital return to work. Taliban insurgents have vowed more tolerance in contrast from their brutal rule decades ago. But a resident in Kabul says women in the capital are now living in fear, choosing to stay at home than risk getting mistreated.
Girls are not out of, from their homes, and they are at homes. And I, and 2 days, I don't see any girls in the street, and in the street in Kabul. They are afraid. They are scared from the Taliban. Think I'm safe in Kabul because it's not the situation that it's before, and we scared from Taliban. Scared from the situation. Our hope, which the Western and the United Nations and the Western countries to help to Afghanistan to election to elect a president, and it's a peaceful government in Afghanistan.
And the United Nations casting doubts over the promises made by the Taliban. On Tuesday, the Taliban held its first news conference since their swift and shocking takeover of Afghanistan. They said they wanted peaceful relations with other countries and would respect women's rights within the framework of Islamic law. But global skepticism has emerged over the group's vow to take a more moderate stance.
I've watched part of the press conference. I think a lot of it will be, we will need to see what actually happens. And I think we will need to see acts on the ground in terms of promises kept.
The Taliban's takeover of Afghanistan unfolded merely days after the U.S. military withdrew from the country. During their previous rule, they stopped women from working and administered punishments, including public stoning and hanging. Girls were also not allowed to go to school. Former U.S. President George W. Bush says he was deeply saddened by Afghanistan's fall, 20 years since he ordered the U.S.-led invasion, which drove the Taliban away from power. He also defended his decision to launch what would become America's longest war.
The Taliban regime is coming to an end.
Former U.S. President George W. Bush, who ordered American forces to invade Afghanistan 20 years ago, on Monday said he and his wife felt, quote, deep sadness watching the chaotic U.S. withdrawal and the Taliban rapidly recapture the country. In a letter, George and Laura Bush wrote, quote, our hearts are heavy for both the Afghan people who suffered so much and for the Americans and NATO allies who have sacrificed so much. Under Bush, U.S. forces toppled the Taliban government in Kabul, who had hosted al-Qaeda militants responsible for the 2001 hijacked plane attacks in New York and Washington. That decision led to 2 decades of haphazard counterinsurgency and efforts at nation building that the Pentagon estimates cost almost $825 billion. And it all seemed to dissolve in just a few days. The Bushes spoke directly to the American service members who battled militants and built roads in Afghanistan, writing, quote, you took out a brutal enemy and denied al-Qaeda safe haven while building schools, sending supplies, and providing medical care. You kept America safe from further terror attacks, provided 2 decades of security and opportunity for millions, and made America proud. We thank you from the bottom of our hearts and will always honor your contributions. But that message might not mean much in Bentonville, Arkansas, where Jill Stephenson remembers her son, Army Ranger Ben Kopp. Kopp was 21 when he was killed in a firefight with Taliban forces in 2009, one of more than 2,300 U.S. military personnel who died there since the invasion.
I do not feel that my son died in vain. I think it's important for me to make that clear. I don't believe that him being there was all for naught.
But the Taliban takeover has stirred strong emotions in this Gold Star mother.
It's very sad and maddening to watch 20 years of blood, sweat, and tears by thousands, tens of thousands of our military just get wiped off, you know, wiped away in the blink of an eye.
Stevenson said she's deeply worried for the future of the Afghan civilians she believes her son was able to help before he died.
I heard firsthand from a seven-year-old little girl the things that she was able to do in her life and the things that she had to look forward to because of the sacrifices made. My heart breaks for her now.
The U.S. has completed a drawdown of personnel from its embassy in Kabul. The State Department says diplomatic staff remaining in Afghanistan are helping with the evacuation of other American citizens and Afghan allies. A White House official says 1,100 U.S. citizens, permanent residents, and their families have been flown out of Afghanistan so far.
Right now, Nick, we're focused on the mission at hand. And the mission at hand is precisely what I was describing to you. That is an effort to relocate, in some cases repatriate to the United States, in other cases to relocate to third countries, as many individuals as we can over as much time as we might have. Right now, we are thinking about this in terms of August 31st. It is safe and responsible for us to potentially stay longer, that is something that we may be able to look at.
Afghans fleeing the Taliban rule have also arrived in the UK Tuesday. Britain plans to evacuate 5,000 people as part of its Afghan relocations and assistance policy. But it also announced a new evacuation scheme that will prioritize women, girls, and minorities.